I'm Andy. I work in the Horus Heresy team in the Warhammer studio. Way back in 2018, when we were working on the Adeptus Titanicus Titans, we deliberately chose a scale, knowing that one day, if all goes well down the line, we would be making tiny little soldiers, and that's what we've done here. The scale that the Legions Imperialis models are designed at is a quarter of the scale of the Horus Heresy models that you're used to seeing, that standard scale. So that's about as small as you can go while still maintaining a distinctive level of detail on the models. There's a number of challenges that come into play when we're designing these models. The most interesting one is just making characterful models at that scale. We feel we've succeeded. We think that from a good few feet away, which is where you would see your models most of the time, they are distinctive, they're characterful, and particularly when you see them multiplied out into a large number. But there are still things you have to do in order to make them work at that scale. You have to break them down into amounts of detail that read properly at that range and that you can assemble. That's a big win, the fact that you can actually assemble these things really, really quite quickly. So the best thing about painting Legions Imperialis is that you can use contrast paints. I myself am painting an ultramarine army. I started off with an Assorman blue contrast over a Lead Belcher base, and that just goes on the tree. You only need to add a few little details after that, and you can paint them really, really quickly, which when you are painting an army with potentially easily over 100 infantry models in, you can paint that in no time. I like to see small versions of those classic, what we call Deimos pattern vehicles. So Space Marine was all about multiples of Rhinos and Predators and Land Raiders, and I love seeing that again. So in my Ultramarines army, I've already painted an entire company of Predators, for example, just because that, for me, epitomises epic. People already using these little models as basing details on their Titans. I've seen Space Marines, you know, being assembled, so they're piling out of the Rhino as it's being crushed beneath the Titan's feet. So there's loads you can do with these things. The Legions Imperialis box set is just the start. It's not a self-contained box game, it's the beginning of an entire range. It is a war game. And like any good war game, it will have a whole range of expansions coming after it. We want people to approach this as a hobby war game, but they just play it as long as they wish.